everyone, and welcome to Akshata's Recipes. Thank you so much for joining me today. So today I'm going to be showing you a mirchi thetsa that is a little bit different from the regular thetsa that you might have had. It's got a little bit of kairi or raw mango and some other ingredients. And this thetsa is really so good. It goes very well with some pitla and bhakri. So after I share the recipe for this particular type of thetsa or, you know, green chili chutney, spicy green chili chutney, I'm going to be also adding my pitla recipe as well as my bhakri recipe at the end. So for those of you who want to stick around and watch the pitla recipe and the bhakri recipe, you can watch it to the end of the video. Otherwise, you can just watch the thetsa recipe. But this is really very nice and it's something very different. And if you haven't ever had it before, then you must give this a try. So let's just head on and start with today's recipe. So friends, let's start with today's recipes. So if you want to see, you can see the pitla recipe at the end as well as the bhakri. I've made rice bhakris. So if you want to see that, you can watch that too. But let's start today with this lovely thetsa recipe, which has got chilies and garlic and raw mango and peanuts. And it's super, super simple to make and the end result is super delicious. So I'm going to start first by peeling a raw mango, also called as kairi. Wash the kairi first very well and then just peel off the peel. Now I'm going to use my cheese grater and I'm going to use the large grater holes and I'm just going to grate all of the pulp till it comes to the mango seed or the mango stone. Now don't discard this stone, you can add it to any curry and you know it will add some lovely flavor to some plain coconut curry. So now I have this shredded raw mango. Let's go through the other ingredients. Now I've got about almost 20 cloves of garlic, about 10 light green chilies and some salt. So I'm going to grind all of this to a very fine paste. Now this thetsa, you can preserve it for about 2 weeks also. So I also have some, so this is my ground paste of garlic, green chili and salt. This is our shredded raw mango. This is about a quarter cup of peanut powder and some salt. So now I've taken a pan and I've added about a tablespoon and a half of oil. Once my oil is hot, I'm going to first start frying this green chili and garlic paste really well till all the rawness of the chilies and the garlic go away. So fry this for about half a minute or so. Then I'm going to add the raw mangoes and the peanut powder. And you can add some salt to taste. Now we're going to fry this for at least a whole minute on a low to medium flame till we get this lovely kind of color. And that's it friends, your thetsa is all ready. Now this goes really well with this pitla as well as bhakri. It's a great combination. So let me take you through how I make pitla. Now I'm using the same green chili and garlic paste, but I'm going to use just about a tablespoon. Beside that I have some chickpea flour and some mustard seeds, some haldi powder, some hing. Don't worry, all ingredients will be given in the description box below. Now I've taken about a cup of besan or chickpea flour and I'm going to add a little water at a time till I get a nice thick paste and there should be no lumps in the paste. It should be extremely smooth. And we don't want it very watery, it should be like a thick dosa batter. So now I've heated about a tablespoon of oil. I've added my mustard seeds, all about a quarter teaspoon, my cumin seeds, my hinga and my haldi. Now I'm going to add just 1 tablespoon of my green chili and garlic paste. I'm going to fry that really well till the rawness of the chili and the garlic go away. And then I'm going to add this besan and water mixture. Keep adding a little more water and whisk this, or you can use a spoon also, but just keep stirring till there are no lumps in this pitla. Now some people like it thick, some people like it thin. It all depends on how much, the water, how much you would like to add. We like it a little bit runny at our place. And I've added a little bit of salt. I'm going to mix all of this very well. And now I'm just going to add a few amsulas.
and we're going to cover this and cook it for about 5 minutes on a low flame. Now you'll get this kind of bubbly consistency, and a different the thickness changes of the pickler. Now all I have to do is just add a little bit of coriander and my pickler is all ready. So now let me take you quickly through my rice flour bhakri. I have uploaded this recipe along with the onion and peanut chutney. I'm just repeating it for those who haven't seen that video. You can go back and check that video out for that chutney recipe too. So I've taken about a cup of rice flour, I've added a little bit of salt, and now I'm going to add hot water to it a little at a time, and I'm going to knead this to a very firm yet soft and smooth dough. Now the kneading of this is very important, so knead this for about 4 minutes, so 3 to 4 minutes exactly, till you get this very nice and smooth consistency of the rice dough, rice flour dough. Now keep your pan heating, so knead this really well, and this is how your dough should look. So then I'm going to divide the dough into two or three parts. I'm going to take a little bit of rice flour, dust it, pat it through my, you know, palms in this form. And then I'm just going to smoothen out the edges with my fingers like this. And you can also use a rolling pin like you would with a normal chapati or roti. And in this way you can prepare your bhakris. This is an ideal combination of bhakri, pitla and thetsa. It's a complete meal and the three of them really go together very, very well. And then we're just going to roast this on our pan. Put some water on one side. And once you get the aroma of the rice flour, you're going to then turn it, flip it on the other side, cook it for some time, and then directly roast it on your flame, and your bhakri is all ready. You'll get this kind of a little bit of black charred effect on both sides. And then just apply a little bit of clarified butter and ghee and enjoy this lovely meal of pitla, bhakri and thetsa.
Hope you like today's recipe, or if you watched all three, then all three recipes. I have many chutney recipes. I've also uploaded a video just a few days ago where I made the same bhakri with some different types of chutney, which is the onion and peanut chutney. So you can go and watch that. I'll leave a link below. Otherwise, if you want to search for that particular recipe, just type rice flour bhakri and chutney, Akshita's recipes, and my recipe will come up first. So that way you can find any of my recipes on YouTube. You just type the recipe and type Akshita's recipes at the side of it. For example, if you're looking for chicken biryani, just type chicken biryani, Akshita's recipes, and my recipe will come up first. So that's the easiest way to find me. Also, at the end of the video, two boxes will show up. Those are my videos. If you want to watch them, just click on them. In the middle of the video, something in white will say suggested. Those are my videos. If you want to watch them, you can watch them. I have more than 500 recipes on my channel, so you can just go and explore and look for whatever you're looking for. So thank you so much for joining me today. And if you like today's video, then don't forget to give it a big thumbs up by clicking the thumbs up icon that you see below this video. Also, if you haven't hit the red subscribe button yet, guys, please do by hitting it. It's just below this video. It's completely free. And once you do subscribe, there's a small bell that will show up. Just click that bell. That way, whenever I put up a new video, you'll get a message for the same. So you won't miss out any of my recipes. So thank you for joining me. Take care of yourself. Stay healthy. Stay fit. Be loving and kind to one another. And I'll catch you soon in my next video. Take care, guys. Bye.